Hello friend, sometime before I created a video on configuration of network devices using Python. After seeing that video, many people approached me telling me that I should create some more useful stuff in this area. Therefore, I have created this script which takes care of day-to-day tasks what a network administrator or a network engineer does. In this small video, I'm going to show you how this what is the use of this Python program, what all it can do. If you like it, you can tell me, I'll give you an explanation of Python program as well. I've uploaded this Python program on GitHub, link is given in description. You can download it, it is available for you. What it does is, there are two files, router helper and router troubleshooting. In this, start from noting down at what time it started, then it creates a object of router connection, where I have provided it what kind of device it is, and it is to be connected using a telnet protocol, the IP of the device, the port, username and password. And here is the lab that you can see how it looks like. There are two routers, router 1 and router 2, similar to the previous lab. The router 2 is shut down. I will switch it on and off during this video, and router 1 is in on state. Its IP is 192, as you can see, 192.168.1.11, port is 2001, and the port for router 2 is 2002 with the same IP. If I click this, you can see it is in a enable mode. The first command, once you get a router object, then it will use this function check connection. There are chances that router is down, then this check connection simply checks whether you can connect to this device or not. If you are not able to connect to this, this check connection will return a false. I am going to run this router troubleshooting program. It is going to print the get BGP summary. This basically does a lot of BGP thing. I am going to explain this, but before that, you can see it has connected to this router. It has brought in this all this information, BGP information, that is very quick. If you see my previous video, I had taken a lot of time to connect the device, enter into the enable mode and all that stuff. Here this class hides all that complexity. Let me put the port at 2002, and what it is going to do is it will try to connect to this router which is in a off state, and in that case the check connection will return false and connection could not be made, router 1 exiting. So this is so quick. You don't have to get into a lot of code to check whether the router is reachable or not. That is the one thing that normally network engineers do. Okay, so you have got this check connection, what it does. Second is a BGP summary. If you see, let me show you what all comes under this router 1. Then this object, you will get check connection, you will get a connect. Using connect method, you can connect to this explicitly. Then you can get the CPU utilization of the device, and you can get the CPU utilization per processes. You can get what all interfaces are there with IP. You can get the logging which is running on the server, that I'm going to show you all this in this small video. Then ping status, you can check whether this router is able to ping the other router or other device or not. Reset prompt is an internal which is being used to reset the enable mode or config mode to the standard mode, standard prompt. Ascend command, if you want to specifically send a command, for example you want to send a command show logging or enable or anything, you can use this and directly send whatever command you want to send using your Python program itself. And there is one more, there is another object here, BGP. This BGP contains some functions which a network engineer uses in context to the BGP interface. For example, get next hop interface, it finds out what is the next hop interface available with respect to that interface. There are multiple interfaces of a router. Then what is the summary of that BGP? This is small command which runs. So what I've done is I've written some more Python code on top of this get BGP summary, and it finds out the specific information which is required for a network engineer rather than going rather than which is being printed by the summary command. Is neighbor down? It simply checks what all, if there is any neighbor connected to that interface, down or up. So you don't have to run the command. It will simply execute this and will tell you whether this neighbor is up or down. Okay, so I'm going to run this router1.bgp.getbgpsummary. It said that BGP router, the IP is 1111, which has been assigned to this interface, and it says that there is a neighbor 222 which is in idle state. It has quickly returned this information. You don't have to write any, you don't have to log into the terminal, write all the commands, get into enable, config, whatever the mode is, to get into the BGP command session and then find out the information. Simply run this and you will get all that information. Okay, so next useful thing that you can get is router1.bgp.isNeighborDown. As you can see here, this router is down. So this command is going to return you the list of all the neighbors which are in down state. As you can see, there is one device connected to that interface in a idle state. Okay, if I switch on this R2 router, it will take some time to boot up. Let's see what is happening on the console. So this is the console of router 2. It is connected. But let's try to see whether it has come up in a up state or not. So that list has gone down. Now the router connected, now it has returned false. So what it means is there is no neighbor connected to this device in a idle state. So this is a common troubleshooting thing that you have to actually go through all the devices. So this is neighbor down does that job for you. It simply finds out all the devices that are connected to all the interfaces and shows you the list of those devices only which are in a down. Let's see the ping status of 2222. What this is going to do is it will try to run the ping command from router 1 to this specific IP. If it is, see, this is true, means it is pingable. Let us try to shut it down and run this command again. Okay, so it has returned false. It means the device is not pingable. Simple, easy thing. Next thing is getting the CPU utilization of router 1. Suppose you are getting some network flaps and you want to know whether the router is overloaded or not, then you will like to get a CPU utilization. So it will say for 5 second area the CPU utilization was 0%. What you can do is you can get the CPU utilization in 5 second, 1 minute or 5 minute interval. So that you can specify. 1 minute is equal to 2, and if you run it, it will give you CPU utilization that has been returned in 1 minute interval. So for 5 seconds is 0000, for 1 minute is 0%. Right, so this is quickly usable for you if you want to get the CPU utilization within 1 minute interval, 5 minute interval or 5 second interval. You just have to specify the parameters. Okay. Next good thing that you can use is get interface IP. This you are going to like. What it does is it finds out all the IPs that are connected to all the interfaces of the device. Right now there are two devices, one is a loopback and one is Ethernet 0000. If you can see E00, right? So this is connected, and here the parameter is only with IP is equal to true. If you are going to do only with IP is equal to false, then you will get all those interfaces along with all the details. As generally you are not interested in on these unassigned interfaces, so you can set it true and run it, and you will get only the interfaces where there is an IP assigned. Next thing you're going to see, I'll show you first of all only drop is equal to false parameter. Okay, but there is a lot of information printed here. You can see there is a lot of information printed here. What a network engineer generally is interested in, total output drops. Here the total output drops are zero, correct? What network engineer interested is in, he needs to find out the name of the interface where there is a total output drop is not equal to zero. This command does exactly this. As of now you can see there is no output. It means there is no interface where there has been a drop detected. In a connected network, if you are getting drops, this command will simply go through all that log and quickly tell you at the specific interface there is a drop. And I've created another class, router troubleshooting, where what it does is it simply scrolls through all these options and tells you what is the problem with respect to that specific device. So suppose you get a problem of a network flap, or you suppose you get a problem that there is no connectivity with some specific device from one device to another device, then you have to actually go through all these things and find out what is the actual problem. So this troubleshooting does is it simply gets the RCA, root cause analysis, RCA in terms of BGP, RCA.getBGP down RCA. So if your BGP was down with respect to 2222 port, so you will simply create an object of router troubleshooting with the object of your router that you have created here, and simply call this function router get BGP down RCA. And what it is going to show you is checking if the BGP is down. It says fail, following devices are down. As you know, this device is down, right? It is going to check further, checking if the ping status. Ping status is also fail, and CPU utilization of this specific device is 0%. So, with this information, it is very clear that problem is not due to the overload of this device. So, this area is neglected. Here it shows that BGP is down on this specific port and the ping status is also failing. So we can simply deduct that device actually is in a down state. So you simply have to go to that specific device and bring it up. Right? Rather than going through all that information, the simple get BGP down RCA gives you quick information what is the problem with that device. CPU utilization problem, overload problem, ping, the device actually is down, or there was a simple flap. And finally, RCA.pol. This is a very useful command, friends. For a network engineer, if in case of a network flap or something, the logs keep on generating into the device. So what you have to do is you actually have to find out all those logs which have come up within last 5 minutes, and you have to run that command quickly. So what it does is RCA.pol, it polls the device within every one second, and if there is anything came up into the log of that device, it simply print that. Right now there is nothing happening here, so the show logging is returning blank. Suppose there is, and generally if you run the command show logging, it prints out a lot of information. Okay, let me show you. You can see there's a lot of information printed. So what you have to find out is, for this specific information, right now the time is 6:30. So you have to find out within last 5 minutes what all logs were generated. You can see last log was generated at 12:52. So this is not useful. So you can safely ignore all this. That you have to do quickly. Again, suppose the logs are getting generated very quickly. So what this does is it goes through. So what it does is it goes through, it runs that command show logging at every 1 second and find out what are the logs generated at what time, and if that time is within last 2 hours or 5 minutes, then it just prints out the log for you. You don't have to actually run that command and scroll through everything what has been printed. There are a lot of options. You can see, you can provide the seconds and interval. Right now you can see the interval is 1 second. You can make the interval to 10 seconds, 5 seconds, something like that. And you can even put that second for how long you want to see, how old logs you want to see here, that you can specify. You can just download it and play with it, and you will come to know that how much you can use it. If you like this, you can let me know what all a network engineer does and they want to do using Python. I'll create the script as well as the informative video for you so that you can use it, and you can download this script from the GitHub, use it. In case you are not able to understand it, you can tell me. I can explain you one-to-one, or I can just create a video explaining all this. So there are two files that you can download. If you think it was useful to you, don't forget to give a thumbs up. And finally, friends, before I wrap up the video, I always do a noble request to all of you. If you think this was useful to you, do a noble cause for this environment, for our society. Here today I'm asking you to save the paper. We cannot say, why I'm asking you to save the paper? Because we cannot run a healthy environment without optimal use of water, electricity and paper. What you can do with paper is don't take printouts. If you think it is very necessary, only then take a printout. If you are using it as a rough work, use both sides of the paper. Avoid taking the bank statements on the paper. Avoid taking hard copies. Avoid using tissues. Use your handkerchief. So many things you can do to save paper. The more paper you are going to save, more trees you are going to save, and you are going to help us, help everyone. Thanks for watching, friends.